Hello students, in last lecture we have seen the different types of the machine elements like nut, bolt and seal screw. Now in this lecture we will study the remaining machine elements and their representation as a freehand sketch for the subject machine drawing. The remaining machine elements that we will study today are different types of the keys, different types of the welded joints, and different types of the springs. So let us start with the different types of the shafts as well as keys. Basically these keys are considered as a basic power transmission elements. You all have seen many types of the different machineries. These machineries require the prime mover, and to transmit the power from this prime mover to the machine we need some sort of alignment or arrangement in between the machine shaft as well as the prime mover shaft. So there are different possibilities of connecting this driver shaft with the driven shaft. Here the driver shaft is considered as the shaft of the prime mover, and driven shaft means the shaft of the machine which receives the power from the prime mover. So consider this example where hub is connected to the machine and the shaft is the shaft of the prime mover. So basically shaft is a rotating machine element used to transmit the power from one location to another. Generally it is having a rotational motion. So to transmit the power from shaft to the hub we need some sort of arrangement in between this. So one possibility is with the help of key we can easily transmit the power between the shaft and hub. So here we can see there is a rectangular slot which is called as key way provided on the shaft, and the same access is also provided on the periphery of hub. So here we are having the taper sunk key. There are different types of the key, sunk key, saddle key. So first we are studying the sunk key. Under this we are having a taper sunk key where taper of 1 in 100 is provided on this key. So this key is placed in the key way and then this hub is placed over the shaft, and when shaft is rotated power is transmitted, torque is transmitted through this key to this hub. So there are many possibilities that many times the machine is overloaded. So in that case to prevent any accidental hazards to the prime mover whose cost is more as compared to the machinery many times, so here we provide another factor of safety or another what we can say as this provision for the safety is the key. So generally in this case whenever the machine is overloaded the strength of the key always is less than that of the shaft. Consider the example of any machine whose capacity is up to 6 kg load. If we add 10 kg load then 4 kg is the additional load on that machine. So in that case because of the excessive load the load is directly acting on the prime mover, and in this case the prime mover may fail. So to prevent any accidental hazard to that prime mover, when the load is suddenly increased as the strength of the key is less than that of the shaft, the key will break and it will prevent any damage to the shaft. As shaft is also prevented, so there is no hazards to the electric motor or prime mover, and this is how we can prevent overloading of any machinery. So here we have seen the application. Now let us study how to represent as a part of machine drawing how we can represent this key, particularly taper sunk key. So in isometric view we have seen taper is provided. In front view this upper rectangle represents the boss, the upper rectangle represents the hub, and this rectangle represents the shaft. In engineering graphics we have studied those features that we cannot see can be represented as a dash line. So there is a shaft, this dash line represents the visible outline of that particular shaft which cannot be seen in front view, so that is represented by the dash line here in both the case. Now this line represents the keyway, access to the keyway, so that we can easily insert this rectangle taper key from this side, which is parallel to the axis. Inside view, if we see, so this one is the proportion, or this one is the projection for the shaft, and this one is the projection for the hub, where W is the width, and here if we consider the total thickness of that key. So this is the parallel key. Now let us study the, this is earlier the key was taper sunk key, now let us study the parallel key. In parallel key, there is no taper provided on this key. Here is the keyway and here is the hub. We insert the key on the keyway provided to the shaft as well as on the hub. This is the representation of parallel key when it is inserted in between the hub and shaft. We can see this key only when we take this section. So after taking the section, this hatching line shows that we have taken the section, and we can easily see this key. And as we have taken the section, so this hatching lines for hub as well as hatching line for shaft. Capital D represents the diameter of this shaft, W is the width, and T is the thickness of that key. Now let us study the different types of these springs. Next machine element are the springs. Everywhere in our day-to-day life we find the application of this type of the spring. Now first type of the spring that we are going to study is the compression spring. So here is the cylindrical helical compression spring of a wire. Springs are made from the wire. That wire could have the circular cross section or rectangular cross section. Based on the cross section of these wires, these springs are classified as circular cross section type helical compression spring or rectangular cross section type helical compression spring. Generally, we find its application in shock absorbers of our two wheeler or four wheeler. Another application we can see in case of ball pen. So this is the view, and this one is the sectional view for this cylindrical helical compression spring. When we take the section here, we could see that as it is having a circular cross section, those circles are represented by the hatching lines, and these are the three center lines. Center line is for the cylinder, and these two center lines are for the wires. Here we are having the simplified form or the symbolical representation of this cylindrical helical compression spring, where it is represented by zigzag pattern of the wire, and this arrow indicates that it is having a circular cross section. Similarly, we are having the cylindrical helical compression spring of rectangular cross section. So here we are having the zigzag pattern, and its circular, which was a circular cross section earlier, now it become as a rectangular cross section. So in simplified form or in symbolical representation, we draw it as an alternate zigzag line, and this arrow indicates that it has the square or rectangular cross section. Next type of the spring are nothing but the spiral spring. These spiral springs are represented by this number of convolution. We called it as a convolution here. So right now we are having, this is number 1 and 2 convolutions. So this one is the 2 convolution spiral spring. The application of this spiral spring we'll find in case of the remote control, where we put that pencil cell. So to position that pencil cell in remote control, we are having this spiral spring. Another application of the spiral spring is the adjustable seat. In case of the car, we can see, we can move that back side of the seat. So that flexibility is provided with the help of this spiral spring. So in case of automotive application, so on the left hand or right hand side of the seat, where we have the provision for moving that seat to and fro on the back side, is possible with the help of spiral spring. Next type of the springs are nothing but the tension spring. The application of this tension spring we will find in case of the spring balance. Spring balance is very good example of this tension spring. Now this tension spring is of different types: cylindrical helical tension spring of wire cross section, that is circular wire cross section, and double conical helical torsion spring of circular cross section. So let us first study the cylindrical helical tension spring of wire circular cross section. So here is the provision for fixing that spring, and here we have the provision for adjustment of the load. So when is load is applied, then it is subjected to the tension, and whenever it is released, again it returns back to its original position. This is the simplified representation of the cylindrical helical spring. Next type of the spring are the torsion spring. The cylindrical helical torsion spring of wire circular cross section is as shown. So the application you can consider in case of clutcher, the girls who attach this clutcher to their hairs. So in that clutcher you will find this type of the torsion spring. Another element where you will find the application of torsion spring is the hand massager. When you wear that finger massager, when we apply the force to that end, so those two ends are held together with the help of this torsion spring. So that exercise or finger massager can be considered as a very good example of torsion spring. Now next we will study what are the different types of the welded joint. First one is the butt weld between the plate and with raised edges. Let me remind you that we are now studying the permanent fastening process. So welded joint comes under the permanent fasteners, whereas nut and bolt were temporary fasteners. So here this one is the illustration for butt weld between the plates with raised edges. This is symbolical representation for that. Second one is the single V butt weld. In single V butt weld, this is the illustration for that single V butt weld, where symbolically it represented as V. Next one is single bevel butt weld. Here is the illustration for single bevel butt weld, and here is the symbolical representation of that single bevel butt weld. Single V butt weld with broad, where we provide the most strength to the welded joint, it is represented by Y. Single U-butt weld, parallel or sloping side, replace that Y which was earlier single V-butt weld, now it is U, replace that Y with U, you will get the single U-butt weld. This is how we done this single U-butt weld joint. Next one is the fillet weld. Whenever two plates are to be welded each other at right angle to each other, we use this type of fillet weld. So as it appears as a right angle, so right angle triangle is the symbolical representation of fillet weld. Spot welding, there is a illustration for spot welding. As there is a spot can be considered as a circle, so that's why it is represented as a circle. Mostly we will find this spot weld, all the utensils in your kitchen are done with the, or welded to each other with the help of spot welding. So utensil rack of your kitchen could be considered as a very good example of spot welding. Next one is the seam weld. This is illustration for seam weld, where two plates are welded to each other by using a seaming joint. So seam joints are represented by circles and two horizontal lines. The very good example is nothing but the where we are having the water tanks, where water tank joints are done with the help of seam weld. Again, whenever we have to connect the two metallic parts with each other, we add the filler material, that could be considered the another application of seam weld. So this is all about filler, different types of the welded joints that we have studied today. So far we have studied different types of the machine elements. We have started with the nut bolt, set screws, different types of the springs, different types of the welded joints, different types of the rivets, and how symbolically we can represent them by using a freehand sketches concept. Thank you very much. Thank you.